story about Melvin McPhee. He's the toughest little twerp you ever did see. If you're in trouble on the playground or at lunch, I tell you that boy packs a serious punch.
The sky grew dark and the thunder barked, and the lightning cracked through the night. The houses shook and the fish in the brook were fanning their fins in fright. But Melvin McBriggle on a red bicycle, who was only just 6 and a half, looked out at the storm and in true hero's form, smiling, just started to laugh. He just laughed. Let me tell you about Melvin now.
Come on, let me tell you about a boy named Melvin.
He said, I'm not afraid, I'm in the second grade, and I can wrestle a lion or two. When a boa constrictor went after my sister, I tied him like the lace of my shoe. My shoe was blue. If you're in a pickle, call Melvin McBrickle. He'll come save you as quick as he can. If you need some help, we'll just give a little yell, 'cause Melvin McBrickle's your man.
What I tell you, that's one tough little man.
Talking about Melvin, yes I am.
Melvin!
When Melvin and cousins who run in the dozens were taking a train to Peru.
Who?
They got stopped at a mountain by a llama who is spouting muddles and puddles of goo. When they asked what they wanted, the llama undaunted said he'd be eating the train. That's when Melvin got mad, and for the llama that was bad, Melvin left them crying in pain. Out in the rain. If you're in a pickle, call Melvin McBrickle. He'll come save you as quick as he can. Now if you need a hand, someone to take a stand, then Melvin McBrickle's your man.
He is a uniquely powerful child. He's an incredible kid, what can I say?
One day at the zoo, a baby tiger turned blue, but everyone was afraid of his mom. The cub had to be saved, but no one was brave enough to lose a foot or an arm. But Melvin was there, and yes, he did dare to take the cub to Dr. Tom. Dr. Tom, with much care, gave the tiger some air, and the tiger gave a good healthy yawn. And his troubles were gone. If you're in a pickle, call Melvin McBrickle. He'll come save you as quick as he can. If you need some help, we'll just give a little yell, 'cause Melvin McBrickle's your man. Yeah, Melvin McBrickle's your man. Melvin McBrickle's your man.
Yo, Melvin, I was wondering, I don't want you to tell nobody or anything, but, you know, this guy's been bothering me. I was wondering if you could come over and, like, check him out and just see what you think.